everyone. In this video, we will cover the current affairs. Before we move ahead, let me inform you that these questions are part of our daily 20 MCQ series in GK Today's Academy Android application. So if you are looking for the text version of these questions and their explanations along with the interactive quiz, you may consider joining our daily 20 MCQ series in Academy Android application. So in this app course, you get daily 20 MCQs, a fortnightly quiz, a monthly revision document, and also category-wise revision ebooks, which are optimized for reading on your mobile itself. Apart from it, you are also able to access all archives of questions from January 2020 onwards. Please check our Telegram channel. The link is given in the description box. You can subscribe to it if you find it relevant. For hard copy books, you can visit our website gktbooks.com. Okay, so now without wasting any further time, let's get started. Good morning, everyone. Welcome back to GK Today. And today we'll be discussing most important MCQs for 24th and 25th of October 2021. Starting with very first question, Pradyumna Nandha, who was seen in the news recently, is associated with which game? So he is an Indian ace chess player and he is one of the youngest grandmasters of the country. Now why he is in news? Because recently he won Julius Baer Challengers Chess Tour by winning against his American opponent named as Christopher Yu. So with this victory, Pragna Nandha has won $12,500 prize money as well as the right to play with an elite set of chess champions at Meltwater Champions Tour in the year 2022. Now apart from it, in the previous lecture we have seen that recently India has defeated Nepal for its 8th SAFF championship title, and this tournament was held in Male. And also during this match, Sunil Chhetri equaled the ace footballer Lionel Messi with his 80th international strike. Okay, then also China has beaten Japan in the Uber Cup finals to reclaim the Uber Cup title, and this is China's 15th Uber Cup title. Also, Indonesia has won Thomas Cup trophy for the first time since 2002 after defeating China. And talking about Uber Cup and Thomas Cup, these are the biennial international badminton championships that is played by the men's and women's national teams of member of BWF, that is Badminton World Federation. Okay. Question number two. Which international space agency has released a climate action plan recently? So the American Space Agency, NASA, has recently released a climate action plan which aims to avert the climate-related impact on its key missions to the space. Also, the plan ensures resilience of NASA's facilities and assets and to provide important climate-related observations to the nations across the globe. Okay? Now apart from it, NASA has also launched a robotic spacecraft named as Lucy, which is set to reach the Trojans, that is asteroid of Jupiter, by the year 2027. And the spacecraft is designed to reach 7 Trojan asteroids along with another one in the main asteroid belt. And the spacecraft was launched using an Atlas V rocket from Florida. Then apart from it, Nebra Sky Disk is said to be the oldest map of stars available on Earth, and it is said to be displayed at the British Museum at London. That's why this disk was in news. Now in the previous lecture, we have seen that actor William Shatner has become the oldest person ever in space, and he flew aboard a Blue Origin rocket ship on a suborbital trip and landed in the Texas desert. Also, we have seen there that The Challenge is the world's first movie to be shot in space. Also, recently, China has launched a 3-person manned mission to its space station for a duration of 6 months in the spaceship named as Shenzhou 13. And this spaceship was launched by Long March 2F rocket. Fine. Question number three, Olaf Scholz who has been in the news recently is associated with which country? So the finance minister of Germany, who belonged to the Social Democrats, has announced a deal to form a new government in Germany. And if successful, he would succeed Angela Merkel as the Chancellor of Germany. Also, last month we have seen that Olaf Scholz's Social Democratic Party won the general elections but could not have a clear or clean majority. Okay? Now, apart from it, SECI, that is Solar Energy Corporation of India Limited, which is a central public sector unit under Union Ministry of New and Renewable Energy, has invited for bids to install 1000 megawatt hour BESS, that is battery energy storage system, and this is in line with Government of India's vision of producing 450 gigawatt renewable energy by the year 2030 and achieve the sustainable development goals. Now, also Germany was in news because recently it has launched world's first self-driving, means automated driverless trains in Hamburg city. So this initiative is actually a part of $70 million Digital Rail Germany modernization plan. And talking about India, Siemens is providing driverless train solutions for BMRCL, that is Bangalore Metro Railway Corporation Limited, to improve efficiency and safety of passengers. Okay? And also we have seen that England has become the first country in the world that has announced to introduce a legislation in 2021 under which all newly built homes will require to have electric vehicle chargers. So now these new office blocks will require to install a charging point for every 5 parking spaces there. Okay? Question number 4. The army of which country won a gold medal at the Cambrian Patrol exercise that was held in the UK? So the Indian Army has bagged a gold medal at the Cambrian Patrol exercise, which was held in UK. And 4x5 Gorkha rifles represented the Indian Army in this exercise. So this competition witnessed representation from 96 armed force teams of nations across the globe. And the competition test the ultimate levels of human endurance and team spirit and is considered as Olympics of military patrolling. Now, apart from it, President of India Ram Nath Kovind has awarded President's Tat Rakshak Medal and Tat Rakshak Medal to Indian Coast Guard personnel. And the awards are given for their act of exemplary gallantry and meritorious services on occasion of Republic Day 2021. Then apart from it, talking about UK, recently the European Union has set out its proposals to change the way the Brexit deal for Northern Ireland is implemented. It was actually an act designed to prevent checks along the borders between Northern Ireland in UK and Republic of Ireland in European Union after Brexit. Okay. Then also we have seen that the Aerial Archaeological Mapping Explorer has been launched in UK to offer virtual flights over the ancient landscapes, and this digital tool will allow the users to see these landscapes from England's past. Okay. Question number 5. Who is the new chairman and managing director of the National Research Development Corporation? So recently Amit Rastogi has taken over as the chairman and MD of NRDC, and he has been appointed to this position after his service of 34 years in Indian Navy. And talking about NRDC, it is an enterprise of DSIR which comes under Ministry of Science and Tech. So this was actually established in the year 1953 to promote the development, promotion and transfer of technologies among various institutions. Okay. Now let's see some of the important recent appointments. First of all, former IAS officer Amit Khare has been appointed as advisor to Prime Minister Narendra Modi. Then V.S. Pathania has been appointed as additional director general of Indian Coast Guard. Then the former Olympic shooter Raja Randhir Singh has been appointed to Olympic Council of Asia's acting president. Then Director General of Border Security Force is Pankaj Kumar Singh and Brand Ambassador of Equitas Small Finance Bank are Rani Rampal, who is the India's woman hockey player, and Smriti Mandhana, and she is India's woman cricketer. Also, Brand Ambassador for Adidas Stay in Play campaign is Mirabai Chanu, and CMD of National Fertilizer Limited is Nirlep Singh Rai. Okay, so these are some of the very important recent appointments. Question number 6, Rozgar Bazaar 2.0 portal, which was seen in the news recently, is associated with which state or union territory? So the Delhi government is set to create the Rozgar Bazaar 2.0 portal as a job matching platform for entry level jobs. So as per the Delhi government, it will offer end-to-end employment related information to those who are searching for jobs in the Delhi. And the site will use artificial intelligence to draw up the best job matches and provide access to skill training, career guidance, and skill credentialing. Okay. Now apart from it, as per a civic report on vector-borne diseases, Delhi recorded over 720 dengue cases and first death in this season. So this is also the highest case count since 2018 for the same period, and over 240 cases have been recorded in 1 week. So this is a matter of concern. Then apart from it, as per the study report by Council of Energy, Environment and Water, 17% of households in Delhi and Tamil Nadu are using some form of electric cooking means. And the rate in Telangana regarding this is 15%, and in the state of Kerala, the rate is 12%. So you can be asked that as per this particular study, which state or union territory has stopped in electric cooking? So this is Delhi. And talking about CEEW, that is Council on Energy, Environment and Water, it is a not-for-profit policy research institution based at Delhi. Also, in the previous lectures, we have seen that New Delhi has launched a patrolling operation named as Operation Satark recently to combat and prevent crimes and make public places more safe. Okay. Question number 7. Kudumbashri is a flagship community-oriented program of which state? So this is a flagship program of the state Kerala, and it is in news because recently the Kerala government has planned to start an online platform to deliver the products manufactured by Kudumbashri and other micro, small and medium production units. Also, the state has inaugurated state level seed capital financial assistance scheme, in which assistance will be given to the self-help groups as part of Pradhan Mantri formalization of micro food processing enterprises. Now Kerala was also in news because recently two of the products have got GI tag from here. First is Adayur chili and second is Kuttiyattur mango. Then also Kanyakumari cloves have got the GI tag, and this product belonged to Tamil Nadu. Then apart from it, Milhi Dana, which is a kind of sweet dish from West Bengal, has been recently exported to the country Bahrain. This is also a GI certified product. Also, the first consignment of Kashmiri walnuts were recently flagged off from Karnataka under One District, One Product scheme. Now, in the earlier lectures, we have also seen that Karappur Kalamkari paintings and Kalla Kuruchi wood carvings have also got the GI tag. And now you have to tell me from which state these products belong to. Please write in the comments. Question number 8. Which Indian entrepreneur has been named winner of Prince William's inaugural Earthshot Prize? So this is Vidyut Mohan, who is an Indian entrepreneur, and he has been named the winner of this particular prize under Clean Our Air category. Why? For his innovation, which recycles agricultural waste into sellable bio products. Also, this prize is called as Eco Oscars, and it is awarded to the innovators who strive to save the planet Earth. Fine. Now let's see some of the important awards. First of all, Alexei Navalny has recently won European Union's Sakharov Prize. Then Kung Fu Nuns has won UNESCO's Martial Arts Foundation Prize. Also, I think 2-3 days back we have seen that the Microsoft team has recently won 2021 C.K. Prahlad Award. Next is Dr. Randeep Guleria, and he has bagged 22nd Lal Bahadur Shastri Award. Then Telugu filmmaker B. Gopal has been chosen for Satyajit Ray Award. And last is the Malayalam writer Benjamin has bagged Weiler Award. Okay. Question number 9. Which month is observed as the Cyber Security Awareness Month? So the month of October is observed as Cyber Security Awareness Month, and it is co-led by National Cyber Security Alliance and the Cyber Security and Infrastructure Agency, CISA, of US Department of Homeland Security. And this year theme was Do Your Part, hashtag Be Cyber Smart. So this month is being observed for 18 years. Also, National Bullying is observed in this particular month. Now apart from it, every year 16th of October is observed as International Observe the Moonlight, which is a kind of event that marks the night when moon is near the first quarter phase. So on this day, the moon will be in waxing gibbous, which is a kind of intermediate phase in which it is not yet full. So the celebration of this event is sponsored annually by the Solar System Exploration Division at NASA. Now in the previous lecture, we have seen that International Day for Rural Women is celebrated on 15th of October, and this year theme was Rural Women Cultivating Good Food for All. Then World Students Day is observed every year on 15th of October in honor of former Indian President APJ Abdul Kalam, who was born on same day. And this year theme was Learning for People, Planet, Prosperity and Peace. Okay. Now last question. Which country has recorded cases of Legionnaires' disease, which is a rare form of pneumonia? So nearly 10 reported cases of this particular disease were reported in New York, USA. And it is a rare form of pneumonia caused by a bacteria called as Legionella. Now apart from it, recently Russia has announced that it is suspending its missions to NATO, that is North Atlantic Treaty Organization, which is an intergovernment military alliance of 30 member countries, of which 28 are European countries and 2 are North American countries. And the headquarters of NATO lies in Brussels, Belgium. Then apart from it, under the Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana, the premium to be paid by farmers is fixed at 1.5% of the sum insured for Rabi crops and 2% is for Kharif crops. And this is 5% for cash or horticultural crops. Now let's start with today's quiz. Here on the slide you can see 5 questions which have been taken from the past 2-3 days current affairs. Pause the video and try to solve each of these questions. And at the end of the lecture, do not forget to share your scores in the comment section. So please be honest and do not cheat with yourself. So that's it for today. I hope you have liked the session. These were the important news and events from today. And we will meet again tomorrow with some more important current affairs. Till then, stay tuned. Thank you so much for watching. And please do not forget to subscribe to GK Today. With this, Meenu Zatsana signing off.